Hey guys, this is Teresa from ZoomSphere, and in this video, I will show you how to set up the scheduler app and schedule your first post. First, install the scheduler app. You can install as many schedulers as you want, and use each of them for different profiles. Click on the red plus button in your workspace and download the scheduler app. Now, you can name your scheduler, and grant access to your teammates who are supposed to use it. Choose the icon and the background color. Then, go to the Data Sources section and connect the social profiles and hit the Save button. Now, when your scheduler is fully set, it's time to create a post. Click on the red plus button anywhere in the calendar. You can select a new post or an idea. For now, choose New Post. Select as many social profiles as you want to schedule your post to, and then choose the type of post. Then add the text. I've already prepared my text in advance and saved it in templates, so I'll just paste it like this. In the text field, you also have the emoji menu, hashtags and templates, and the organic targeting. In the real view window, you can see the picture size requirements supported for the type of post. You can upload your picture using the drag and drop or the browse to upload option. If you have uploaded a bigger picture than supported for the automatic publishing, you can easily edit it in the image editor, where you can quickly edit the picture, for example, use various filters and easily apply cropping presets. If your post is identical to the Facebook one, save time by clicking the copy from button and duplicate your post. It works for all platforms and you can still edit the text and also the image. Now, there are two types of publishing. You can either choose auto-publishing, meaning ZoomSphere will automatically publish your post at the chosen time, and it's available for all social media platforms. There is also manual publishing, which means that upon installing ZoomSphere mobile app, you will receive a push notification on your phone when it's time to publish the post. This publishing method is used for Instagram only, for stories, IGTV, reels, and carousels. For each post, you can pick a label and a tag. This way, you can easily organize your posts and later on, you can export them using the label filters. If you don't like the default label option, you can create your own in the main settings. Now, the most important thing. Set the date and time for publishing and select the status. Remember, only the approved status is a signal for ZoomSphere that the post is ready to be published. Without applying this status, ZoomSphere will not publish your post. You can adjust the status setting according to your needs and also create new ones. Statuses are visible to each scheduler role differently. See the permission in the status settings, which is located on the bottom of each scheduler. Remember though, only the master account can do so. If you're sure that your post is ready to be published, choose the approved status. But you can also set up a fully customizable approval workflow if your post needs to be reviewed and approved by another team member. If so, set the status to approve. And there are two ways how you can mention your teammates for approving. Mention them in the comment section. Enter their email address in the status settings and they will be notified automatically. In the comment section, you can find a discussion with client and internal comments. Your teammates with scheduler role client can only interact in the section discussion with client and scheduler role admin and editor in the internal comments section. Like this, you don't have to share your internal comments with your client. Once you mention someone, an email notification will be sent along with the bell notification. Next to the internal comment section, you can see the activity log, which records the post's edit history. If you would like to duplicate your post, you can click on the three dots in the corner of the post miniature and choose Duplicate to the original date or to a current date. If you want to remove your post, click again on the three dots and choose Remove, or open the post and at the bottom of the left corner, hit the Delete Post button. The blue Follow button is super important for manual publishing. If you have it switched to following, you will receive a push notification to your ZoomSphere mobile app when it's time to manually publish your post. Also, following means you will receive notification from the app even for comments without mentioning you specifically. And also that the dot notification indicating new content will appear on the app title. This setting icon is in each app, and the person who created the app can manage the app access, social profile connection, and so on. If you didn't create the app, you cannot change this setting. The owner just shared the app with you. Thanks to the activity section, you can view the latest changes of posts, added comments, and mentions. Remember, you can only see the changes and mentions to the post you have the right to engage according to the post status. You can filter out posts in the Scheduler app according to the calendar view, profiles, labels, tags, statuses, users, and sites. The calendar export allows you to download the post overview. Simply edit the time period, adjust the filters, choose if you want the PDF or the Excel file, and hit the export button. Both formats show all available information about the posts, including the visuals. If you have connected at least one Instagram account, the Instagram feed feature will be available. Like this, you can see the final look of your Instagram feed and plan it accordingly. You can open the settings and choose which statuses Instagram feed will show. When it comes to the calendar itself, you can change the calendar view option. If you work with more than one scheduler, you can easily switch between the schedulers using the scheduler switch. At the bottom of each scheduler, you will find the status bar with status and idea settings. Only the master account can change the status setting and create new statuses for each scheduler. The visibility of each status is controlled by the read and write permission for each scheduler role. That's how you can fully customize the workflow. The read permission allows the person to see the post, and the write permission allows the person to edit the post. The private draft status is visible only to its owner, and no one else can see the post. By default, the approved status is the only status that publishes the post. The master account can adjust and create new statuses according to their needs. There are three user roles for scheduler: the admin, editor, and client. Each of them has different options. The admin role has the Publish Now button available and can engage in the discussion with client and in the internal comments section and see the activity log of the post. The editor role doesn't have the Publish Now button available, but also can engage in all the communication channels. The client role has only access to discussion with client section and doesn't have the access to the post activity log. Set up a role for your teammates for each social profile. Go to the main settings and open the user and team and open the user's profile, and in the data sources, select the social profile icon, assign a role, and hit the save button. Now everything is set up and you can start scheduling. Have fun!